And moving on, I'd now like to request our next presenter to please join us on stage. We have with us Mr. Rakesh Markhedkar, President, Bajaj Electricals. He's going to do his presentation on utility. Comes with a rich experience of leading and managing implementation of wide spectrum of projects, namely EHV, transmission lines and substations, power distribution projects, thermal power plant, cement plant, and a lot more. Let us put our hands together as I request Mr. Markhedkar to please join us on stage. Let's put our hands together as our next speaker joins us on stage. Thank you.
Good afternoon, friends. So since morning we are listening, let me introduce myself. I'm Rakesh Markhedkar from Bajaj Electricals. Since morning we are talking about smart cities, smart grid, lot of smart things are now, smart and intelligent things we are talking for last 1 or 2 years. So now it is really time to look into whether how smart we are today and how we need to become a smart in true sense to cater the need of a smart city. So I am going to talk about the power utility scenario to cater 24/7 smart electricity. We'll talk about the power sector snapshot, challenges of power utility, crisis faced today, DISCOM's bottleneck, the power distribution bottleneck, measures to check these losses, national grid, power infrastructure required for smart cities, high capacity corridors for the transmission, investment, funding program and future outlook. Just to show you about the cycle of value chain for the power, right from the generation, then the transmission, that is the central utility power, interstate, then via state power, sub-transmission, power distribution to the domestic and industrial use. Let us see where we are worldwide. We are the third largest transmission network of the world, third after US and China, and fifth in power generation. We have acute power shortage of 10 to 14%, with a peak shortage of 14%. We have an average of 970 per capita electricity consumption, as Mr. Minister said this morning, is well below the world average. We have inadequate generation capacity addition and high level T&D losses, transmission and distribution losses. Apart from this, the one good thing is happening now, we are also concentrating on renewable energy, and there is a plan to execute big corridors of transmission network for these renewable energies. What are the challenges we have today in the power transmission segment? There is a big gap between the transmission and distribution, and this is the gap between the demand and supply. Every year it is increasing. You can see the T&D losses in the states. AT&T losses are very high. The distribution franchise, distribution companies are under debt. That is in the range of $35 billion, very significant. The challenge is, this is the matching development in the infrastructure of the transmission and distribution. The expectations and the directions are not matching as per the speed and pace. Lot of correlation and coordination is missing between the generation and transmission. It is a huge gap. Even today we have the generation capacity of 2,35,000 the megawatt, but highest at any point we are able to utilize only 1,60,000 megawatt. And there is a lot of reason between the slippages of the power in the transmission and utilization of the power generated. What are the crises we are facing today? As I said, distribution sector financial losses is 60,000 crores. This is the FY12 figure. Cost of power deficit itself is a costing of around 43,800 crores annually. That's a bank exposure to DISCOM. It's not in good healthy shape. The debt equity ratio is gone to 2.64 in FY13 as compared to 0.91 in 2009. As I said, 33 gigawatt as power generation is in question mark in terms of the availability, coal, gas and investment proposals. Let us see about now what are the bottlenecks in the power distribution, the utility. One is under investment and overstress, overburden system. Revenue covers only 70 to 75% of the cost itself. And there is the overloading of the transformers and inappropriate ratio of STLT lines. Outdated rules, regulations, management structure and practices, lot of things we have here, the power distribution utilities facing nowadays these bottlenecks. Coming to the AT&C losses, that is aggregate technical and commercial losses. You can see that some of the states are above even the 40. And when we work there, we have seen that some of the districts in the country which is above 80% losses in some of the states. So this is a very serious concern. Before we talk about the smart grid, smart cities, smart power, 24/7 utility and electricity availability, these are the things major really causes of worries. If you see worldwide, which is the figure for the T&D losses, against the world average of 9.17%, today we are around 26 to 28%. So what are the checks are required to reduce this AT&C losses? You know, nowadays a lot of initiatives taken by Government of India, like separation of the feeders, replacement of this conductors with the EPC cables, replacement of the aging instruments and the transformer, other equipments and all. So this is a really big challenge. We need to work on these fields so that we can really work on reducing this AT&C losses. Some of the initiatives what I said is like the indigenous development are highest, the transmission system voltage in the world. Now we have commissioned the country as a 1200 ultra extra high voltage AC system. This is a proud moment. Some of the projects we have taken in the transmission smart city project just started implementation. Some of the pilot distribution smart projects also in the pipeline. Only one in the country so far is completed, that is for the Pondicherry. We are talking about the superconductivity technology development as a pilot project, but it is very far from the ground reality. Now let us talk about the smart, the grid, national grid evaluation. You have seen in the coming years, the previous years, how the initial there was a five one nation, five grids, and all the grids were having five frequencies. The slowly we have started integrating those grids with that. But it's a proud moment in December 2013 that the biggest isolation of the southern grid also we got synchronized. So now we can say we have a one nation, one grid with one frequency. These are the advantage of rich and the per unit energy charges, that vibrant electricity market will have development. So what are the things are required when we talk about the smart city? What are the power infrastructure requirement? We need to modernize power system for a smart city through designing, automation and remote monitoring and control. We need to have an underground cabling system, the proper underground system with the connected proper ring bands and the cities and for the distribution utilities. We need to have a mechanism of automatic shifting, rerouting the power, shifting of the load, controlling the generation to manage the constraint of the outage of the network, monitoring and condition monitoring of the power transmission and distribution network, and on top of that, offering better consumer services. So this itself is a big infrastructure need, because we need to do an integration of the telecommunication system and automation, IT with the system, so that we can have a proper infrastructure to cater the smart city need. These are the areas where that government of India has already planned a lot of things for the investment in these categories, whether it is the STLS conductors, multi-circuit GIS, compact towers, the formation of the national grids. A lot of things are going on in terms of the technology. These are the things where the development is already started. In terms of the investment in the absolute terms, rupees, you see around 20,000 crore rupees approximately investment, 1 lakh crore per annum, approximately 1 lakh to 120,000 crores investment in the power sector, comprising approximately 50-50, generation 50, transmission, distribution put together 50%. This is the investment is planned. The future outlook for the 12th plan, this 110,000 circuit kilometer transmission capacity addition has been planned. At the same time, if we talk about the substation capacity, 270,000. The proud moment, indigenous development of 1200 kV ultra high voltage AC system. Now we have test charge. So the big contribution is done with the PPP. Now we have some advancement in the technology and operation and maintenance with the hot light maintenance, emergency restoration systems, so online washing of the insulators and thermovisioning scanning. R&D initiatives are on to make this 1200 kV EHV ultra high voltage AC system to take in as a main transmission system of the country. With this, thank you very much. I have been allotted 10 minutes time, so let us hope to have a good 24/7 electricity to cater the dream of our smart city concept. Thank you very much. Yeah, I'm going again back.
Thank you so very much, sir. What a pleasure, and thank you for keeping the time limit in mind. Let's put our hands together for him, and may I once again request Sunita to please join us on stage and acknowledge the presence of our speaker. Ladies and gentlemen, let us put our hands together as we present a token of appreciation to Mr. Markhetkar. What a pleasure, sir. Thank you once again.